for this evening. This game comes up between the Heineken Hotshots and Sagicor Grandi Boys team. We're asking both teams to please line up. And once again, remember to place all t-shirts inside your track pants. We're just about ready. The umpires are on their way out on the field. The spectators are ready. So the umpires for this game, Mr. Glenroy Cox and Mr. Kirk Bugo. That's our two officials for this game. So in random order, we'd like to call upon the Sagicor Grandi Boys team as they make their way out. Akeem Alvarez, Chris Patia, Ryan Quilden, Mikael Barrett, Kapil Harry, Ravi Khan, Dylan Patia, Avin Charles, Wendell Allen, Ryan Sarup, and Kevin Batiste. That's your 11 for the Sagicor Grandi Boys team. As you see them marching out to the center, they'll be coming up against your home team, the boys in green, the Heineken Hotshots. And in random order, they are David Pariag, Kester Cupidor, Mikael Budusing, Andre Weston, Sheldon Thomas, Trevor Rajkumar, Brandon Singh, Sean Cupidor, Josiah Grazette, Stefan Pierre, and Daryl Cupidor. That's the guys in green, the Heineken Hotshots. As you see them heading out to the center, this should be an encounter full with action, folks. So let's just sit back and enjoy the Super Sevens cricket action.
I on chill, chill. I on chill, chill.
Skippers to the center, Daryl Cupidor and Chris Patia. Cupidor with a coin in hand. Numbers is the call by Patia. And it's a bird's toss. So, the skipper, Cupidor, you have won the toss. And it seems as though he has sent in the Sagicor Grandi Boys to bat first. So, there you have it first. The Heineken Hotshots have won the toss. And they've elected to send Sagicor Grandi Boys in to bat. So, the guys in the blue and green tops with the black track pants will have first strike. And the boys in green, they will be in the field. So just hang on a few minutes, folks, and you will see cricket action at its best on the way.
Have a good time now, bring all your friends and enjoy the line now. When you hear the horn, just know you can't test. We is six in the place. You can't handle it.
Remember, folks, the winner of this game will go on to meet the winner of the previous game, which is the Flavorite Avengers. Congratulations once again to them. And Gunners will meet Hard Drive. That game takes place tomorrow. And Spartans will play Hamas. That game also takes place tomorrow. So Gunners Hard Drive and Spartans Hammers tomorrow evening. And on Wednesday, we'll see Oilers coming up against Surprise Utes. And Avengers will come up against the winner of this game. Also on Wednesday, Mix Up Boys will be coming up against the 1-2-3 Print Players in their first semi-final game. Remember, only 8 teams in that division. And that went on to the Big Four or semi-finals. So one or first place 1-2-3 Print Players will play fourth place, the Mix Up Boys team. So that's it for tomorrow and Wednesday. We'll fill you in with some more information as we go along. Remember, this is the journey to the finals. It's win or go home. As we see the opening pair in the crease for the Sagicor Grandy Boys team, it looks like Akeem Alvarez and Kapil Harry, the batsman on strike, Alvarez, and with the ball in hand, Mikel Budu Singh, a.k.a. Buddha, and he'll be coming from the commentary end. The boys in green coming up against the boys in blue. Cricket action about to get on the way. So it's Budu Singh into Alvarez, first delivery. And that one is a wide one. So umpire Burgos, with his outstretched arms, he signals the first wide of this game. So the first delivery by Budu Singh, a wide one. The left-handed Akeem Alvarez on strike. As Budu Singh comes in, shortest delivery, and he's bowling. So that's the first wicket here for this Heineken Hot Shots team. As we see the Duckman belting out onto the field, Akeem Alvarez has to go. He goes without troubling the scorers. This for one for one.
I don't chill, chill.
And the sweet sounds of the young superstar DJ Geo just playing some music there from Pretty. And just so you know, as a matter of information, folks, come this Sunday the 14th, you will be able to see Pretty live right here on Four Roads Recreational Grounds. He'll be performing right here this Sunday as Budu Singh continues his over. He will be coming in to Mikel Barat. Barat replaces Alvarez, the dangerous left-handed in-form Akeem Alvarez. He was dismissed early. Bowled down there by Budu Singh. So Budu Singh to continue into Barat. So Barat just playing carefully here. Some excellent bowling here from Budu Singh. He's being cheered on by his teammates. And remember, this batsman on strike, Mikel Barat, the first and only player in this competition to hit 6 sevens off of one over. So all eyes will be on him this evening as Budu Singh continues with an excellent over so far. Just two more deliveries remaining, only the one wide coming from it. So Budu Singh into Barat. And he has Barat right where he wants him. He is being cheered on as we see the Duckman walking with some sort of paraphernalia here in his hands. Somebody is having a wake this evening, folks. So will it be the Heineken Hot Shots? So will it be the Sagicor Grandy Boys? As we see Barat just gently playing that ball down there to the boundary, and he picks up 4 runs. So at the end of over number one, the score 5 for the loss of 1. Akeem Alvarez being bowled out in this opening over. 5 for the loss of 1. Over number 2 coming up as I hand you over to the young superstar, DJ Geo.
Soaking wet, and I'm up in every fet. It could be hot sun or storm, it's fet till I'm falling down, 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 I'm falling down.
down, say look up falling. Girl and them like they want me.
And it seems as though the Four Roads Recreational Grounds has finally come to life. Spectators in the pavilion now standing on their feet. This is the kind of atmosphere we will need to see come Sunday, because trust me, we have lots of surprises in store for you. The Digicel Girls will be here. Music Truck Trailer, we will be airing live on Wii Sports. Sunday is going to be a big day. This is the journey to the grand finals, the first ever Super Sevens Windball Cricket Tournament, hosted by Strictly FX and the Four Roads Sports Movement. So Daryl Cupidor, the skipper of the Heineken Hotshots team, to continue. And his first delivery is flicked off the legs here by Kapil Harry. And that score now moving on to 9. Harry off the mark. He picks up 4 runs. So both these batsmen on 4. The total now stands on 9 for the loss of 1. So keep it all into Harry. This ball travels down the road to the long on area. Fieldsman picks it up with one hand. Back into Cupidor. Cupidor with his arms on his hips. So with that single, we see Mikel Barrett coming on strike. So Cupidor into Barrett. 2 short steps. He comes in. Excellent delivery there from Cupidor. Barrett having no choice but to play that delivery right back to the bowler. As we see the duckman in the distance with a lit candle. Cupidor into Barrett. Slower delivery there from Cupidor. Wicket keeper Pariag with the ball in hands. So some good bowling here from the Heineken Hotshots team. Just 5 runs coming off of Budu Singh's first over. And another 5 coming off of Cupidor's over so far. He still has 2 more deliveries. He comes in with his 5th delivery to Barrett. And big swing there from Barrett. That ball just missing the bat. And Barrett playing all over it. So 1 more delivery remaining in Cupidor's over. And the score 10 for the loss of 1. So Cupidor with his final delivery. Tick edge there from Barrett. Fieldsman running it down. Being able to stop it, picks up 2. Not out, says the umpire. So at the end of over number 2, the score 12 for the loss of 1. In the background, the sounds of the young superstar mixmaster DJ G.
I don't chill, chill, I don't chill, chill.
When we touch down, we won't play shell long. When we touch down, we won't play shell long. When we touch down, we won't play shell long. When we touch down, we won't play shell long. When you see we juve manin, all we do is chip, chip. Behind the top juve manin, we black and we green, see. All a girl inside a man, make she then a stick, she. Jam like we don't give a damn, we mad and we sick, sick. Juve manin ringing bell, moving like we come.
So DJ Gio there just waking this crowd up as we see some of the spectators just coming to life and dancing their hands in the air. We hope to see them on the cruise come the 19th of this month, the Labor Day holiday. Remember, it's all about the Treasure Queen. Our very own Four Roads Sports Movement will be hosting a cruise on board the Treasure Queen. I think we have just about 3 tickets left. Ken would have those tickets in his back pocket. Yes, he does. So David Parag to continue. He'll be coming from the commentary end. And he'll be coming into Kapil Harry, the batsman on strike. Big swing there from Harry. A dot ball. So the captain, Cupidor, just making some changes in his field. Parag with his second delivery into Harry. Big swing and a slash there from Harry. just picking up a single, and that brings Barrett on strike, Mikel Barrett. Might I remind you folks that this batsman hit a bowler for 6 sevens in one over. So all eyes on him. Not counting out a Kapil Harry. He is known on the windball circuit. He also plays hardball cricket. So Parag to continue into Barrett now. Some excellent bowling from Parag. So Barrett being contained and restricted, not being able to get a full swing of the bat. Score now 14, still for the loss of one. As Parag comes into Harry. Big swing there from Harry, and that ball just getting under the bat of him. So Parag being cheered on by his teammates, and he still has two more balls remaining. Parag into Harry again. Big swing. And just beating the fieldsman there. So that ball just smashed it through the point area. Harry picking up four runs. And this total moving on now to 18 for the loss of one. It seems as though it's Keston Cupido. So Barrett just having a few words there with Harry. So Parag with his final delivery here in his over into Harry. Slower delivery, excellent bowling there, excellent thinking from this bowler, and that's the end of over number three. The total 18 for the loss of one. The fourth over coming up in just a short, and in the background a DJ, a Geo, the mix master, the young superstar. He'll be coming on the cruise on board the Treasure Queen June 19th.
Hey, oh, chill.
Got them best friends and them there. All eyes put them up in here. We gonna make some mess in here. We gonna make some mess in here.
So
got
them
best friends and them there. All eyes put them up in here.
So got.
And remember, folks, we will be shutting it down this Sunday 14th for the grand finals right here on Four Roads Recreational Grounds. Tell your friends, tell your family. We will be building a big bleachers all the way back down on the western side against the fence to try to accommodate all of the spectators as Daryl Cupido continues with the fourth over. And Barrett, the man on strike, immediately dispatched that one for seven. So Barrett is on his way, the first seven of this innings. Mikel Barrett now moving on to 14. Harry on 10, and the total 25 for the loss of one. So keep it out to continue. He's coming into Barrett. Barrett gently playing that ball back down in the third man area. And he picks up four more runs. So it's a seven and then a four. This total moving on now to 29.
Soka.
This is over number four, folks. One wicket loss so far. The wicket of Akeem Alvarez. Remember, he went for a duck being bowled out by Budu Singh. Cupido just making some field adjustments here. Barrett, the man on strike. As Cupido comes into him. So, a much better delivery there from Cupido. Barrett just defensively playing that back down. So, Cupido into Barrett again. Excellent delivery there from Cupido into the toes of Barrett. So some fierce faces going on between the batsman and the bowler. Barrett just asking how many more deliveries there. Cupido into Barrett again. Big swing there from Barrett. And Cupido seems a bit more confident. Just staring into the face of Barrett. One more delivery and his over. So that's the end of the fourth over. A good comeback here from Darrell Cupidor, shaking his head. Just 11 runs coming off of that over. The score 29 for the loss of one. Over number 5 coming up right after this.
Soca, Soca, I owe chill, chill.
And remember, come this Sunday, folks, it's going to be a fete right here on the Forest Recreational Grounds. Lots of entertainment, lots of action, plenty cricket action. We will be doing it like a boss right here. Diggle Martin, Forest Recreational Grounds. The action starts from 5 p.m. Be sure to come out early, get your seats. DJ Gio will be here. DJ Squeeze will be here. Zimmy will be here. DJ David will be here. Everybody will be here. You are the only missing entity. Come out early. So with number 13 on his back, Andre Weston, the new bowler from the commentary end. He'll be coming into Kapil Harry. Big swing there from Harry. And this seems as though it's a drop catch here by the wicketkeeper. So this total now moving on to 33-0 for the loss of one. And it's Weston into Barrett now, the dangerous Barrett. Big swing there from Barrett. So Weston, two good deliveries from him. Barrett now on 18, Harry on 11. As we see the skipper of the Hotshots team, Cupidor, just making some adjustments in his field. Remember, folks, this is a game time. It's win or go home. As we see the Duckman still on the outside with his candle in hand. Somebody's going to have a wake this evening. He's awaiting. So Weston to continue. A big swing there from Barrett. So Barrett just taking it on the pads. There's some good bowling here from Weston. He's being cheered on by his team. So Weston with still three more deliveries. He will continue into Barrett. Barrett just playing a sort of a paddle shot there, picking up a single that brings Harry on strike. So Weston with still two deliveries remaining in his over, and that total now 31 for the loss of one. Remember, folks, tomorrow it's the Autorama Gunners coming up against Hard Drive and the Big Screen Spartans. They will meet up the Earth to Move Hammers. That's tomorrow. As Weston comes into Harry. Big swing there from Harry. This one clears the breadfruit tree. But that's a maximum of 7 runs. And what a shot that is by Kapil Harry. And it seems as though Harry just got permission to mash this place up. The score now moving on to 38. As Weston continues into Harry. And an excellent comeback there from Weston. And that's the end of Weston's over. The score, 38 for the loss of one. Weston getting just 9 runs in his over. Over number 6 coming up. We are here with our friends. That's the sound of my friend in the background, the young superstar, mixmaster, DJ Gio. And if you're enjoying this game, folks, let me hear you. Come this Sunday, 14 June, folks, somebody, one of these teams will be popping bottles, because this Sunday we will have a winner. This is what it was all about. It comes down to this. The journey is now on the way. We are down to 7 teams. We are in search of an 8th team. We are looking for the winner of this game here between the Sagicor Grandy Boys and the Heineken Hotshots. Who will it be? Who is your money on? As we see Trevor Rajkumar, the veteran, he is coming from the coconut tree end, and an excellent delivery there from him. As we see Buru Singh trying to chase that one down, 4 buys, a signal by the umpire. So Rajkumar to continue. He's coming into Barrett. Foolish delivery. A play right back to Rajkumar. So lots of support in the field here from the Heineken Hotshots team. Rajkumar being cheered on as he continues his third delivery. Barrett driving that ball straight back down the road, and the fieldsman just coming right in front of it. That's the end of the dangerous Mikel Barrett. The Heineken Hotshots now have the Sagicor Grandy Boys 43 for a loss of 2. That's the wicket of the dangerous Barrett, as we see Ryan Quinlan coming out to the center. He replaces Barrett and bearing on his back number 20.
She love the sensation. She's styling neurotic. Buying that waist and don't stop it, don't stop it, don't stop it. From New York to Jimmy, condense all the DB. Roly poly or skinny, any man in this wine they give me. Soak up with her baseline. Make she don't waste time now. Shorty is murder. Oh lad, I want you wind up your waist in front of me.
So Rajkumar picking up a wicket, Josiah Grazette, the fieldsman, coming around and picking up that catch. So the Sagicor Grandy Boys team now 42 for the loss of 2. As we see an excellent shot being played by Harry here, going straight through the arms of this fieldsman, and that's a flat 7. This total moving on now to 49. So Rajkumar to continue into Harry. Big swing there from Harry. This one goes all the way down to Grazette. Same fieldsman. So Grazette picking up that catch there. Rajkumar picking up another wicket. The total now 49 for the loss of 3. In the background, DJ Gio, the young superstar, the mixmaster himself.
Ooh, yeah, 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 yeah.
She ball out, oh lad. She grab on me thing like, oh lad. And then I give she the thing like, oh lad. I mash up the place and you know you're whining good.
She ball out,
oh lad. Just give me some time now,
oh lad.
She want me to down the whiner,
oh lad. But you're something feeling good,
nah, nah.
And she ball out, oh la, oh la, oh la, oh la, oh la, oh la, oh la. She ball out, oh la, oh la, oh la, oh la, oh la. She got me deep. She ball out, oh la, oh la, oh la, oh la, oh la, oh la, oh la. Oh la, oh la, oh la, oh la, oh la. She got me deep.
So in the center now, folks, we have two fresh batsmen, the likes of the left-handed Ryan Quinlan and the skipper of this Sagicor Grandy Boys team, Chris Patia. He makes his way to the center and he replaces Harry as he was caught out in the deep in the long-on area by Josiah Grazet. Rajkumar being rewarded with that wicket. This one is drived down to the long-off area. Fieldsman picking it up with one hand back into Rajkumar. So Patia off the mark, and that's the end of Rajkumar's over. That's the end of the sixth over, if I'm not mistaken. So the seventh and final over coming up. The score 51 for the loss of 3. 50, my apologies, 5-0 for the loss of 3.
Don't worry, but I can't promise I ain't go ride on nobody. Cause the road have too much woman, well woman. Cause the road have too much woman, sweet woman, woman. Cool yourself, I play you with an X-Man. You play with someone else. I want time in your section. Watch me, I pass, so when you're done, you could meet me on the junction. Back and I start, I ain't the master, but I'm ready for action now. Fine in time.
So after picking up two catches in the deep, Josiah Grazet, he will be bowling the seventh and final over for this Heineken Hotshots team. He will be entrusted with this over by his skipper. He'll be coming from the commentary end, and he's coming into Chris Patia, the batsman on strike. The total stands at 50-5-0 for the loss of 3. So this is over number 7, folks. The final over of this innings. As Grazet comes into Patia. Patia making contact. Oh, and a chance of a run out. Just scrambling through there for a suicidal single. Nevertheless, they make it through. And with that single, we see the left-handed Ryan Quillen coming on strike. Total now moving on to 51. So Grazet to continue. He changes. He's coming around the wicket to Quillen. Big swing there from Quillen. This one tosses up in the air. Fieldsman settling under it. Oh, and it's dropped. So the fieldsman not being able to judge that ball correctly. And Quillen lives to see another day. So two balls gone, two singles coming from it. The score of 52 still for the loss of 3. As Grazet continues now to Patia, he comes in, a slower delivery. Rajkumar with a one-handed catch, what an excellent catch from Rajkumar.
This is
a no ball, as we see no ball being signaled by the umpire.
You like that, huh?
So Patia is also spared a no ball signal by umpire Burgos. So some excellent fielding here from the veteran, the old man in the field, Trevor Rajkumar. He's going to have to rock some Bengay on that arm this evening. So Grazet continues, and a dot ball welcomed by his team. And the score now stands at 54-5-4 for the loss of 3. Remember, folks, this is a win or go home. No time to play. Grazet with his fourth delivery. Excellent delivery there from him. Batsman just scampering through for a single. That total moving on now to 55. So in this final over, Grazet here being cheered on. The fieldsmen just clapping on their bowler. So just two more legal deliveries remaining in this innings. As Grazet runs up, he comes in, delivers to Patia, and that one just crashes through the cover area. Patia picking up four runs. The total now moving on to 59. 59 for the loss of three. So just one more ball in this innings. One more ball and Grazet's over. So final delivery here from Grazet into Patia. And this one is just flicked, lands on top of the pavilion, and that's a seven. So at the end of the seven overs, the total 66 for the loss of three, 67 required for victory by the Heineken Hotshots team. We will see exactly how they approach these runs coming up in just a short as I hand you over to Mixmaster DJ Gio.
Attention!
Just a quick reminder, folks, for those of you who like to enjoy the T20 cricket action, Beesh Sports Foundation, together with CNAT Auto Parts, they have been hosting a T20 cricket tournament all the way down in Beesh. And some of these players right here on this Sagicor Grandy Boys team, they will be taking part in the quarters and semi-finals. Their grand finals comes up on the 19th of this month. And on that day, we also have our cruise. Yes, our Four Roads Sports Movement will be hosting a cruise on board the Treasure Queen. The likes of Mixmaster Gio, Squeeze, and DJ Cut Cost, they will all be on board the Treasure Queen. As I hand you back over to the man himself, the young superstar. He stands behind me just about 4.5 feet tall. The man himself, DJ Gio.
With somebody,
I don't chill.
Somebody. And we ain't gotta tell nobody. We ain't gotta tell nobody.
Nobody.
Why can't everybody know what's good? But some gon' hate what's new. We just do our thing, no time to waste. Always playing it cool.
And at the end of the night when the lights go out, when we turn down, oh no, we won't.
We ain't never turn down. We ain't never turn down.
And when they try to make us leave, we turn and say we're never going home.
And you know just what I wanna do. I wanna rock with somebody.
Take a phone and the ID, can't post me on IG, but them thoughts, they be creeping, try to catch yourself while I'm sleeping, go too far, you need a task force,
I don't chill,
got a glass court, thoughts try to camcord, that's a long shot, I'm short from half court,
soon as the bottles start coming out, she come running to my couch, Shelly, yo, never trust a big butt in a smile, you can't trust hot, soon as the liquor start running out.
And remember, folks, coming up tomorrow from 6:45 p.m. we will see the Autorama Gunners. They come up against Hard Drive in their quarterfinal match, and then the Big Screen Spartans, they will be playing the Earth to Move Hammers in their other quarterfinals encounter. That's the two games carded for tomorrow. And on Wednesday, we will see the Carib Oilers. They will be playing the Surprise Utes, as we saw them winning their game yesterday. Also on Wednesday, the Flavor Right Avengers will be coming up against the winner of this present encounter here between the Sagicor Grandy Boys and the Heineken Hotshots. Also on Wednesday, we see the 1-2-3 Print Players. They will be coming up against Mix-Up Boys. So Wednesday, 3 games. Tomorrow, 2 games. You're in store for some great cricketing action as I take you back over to the man himself, DJ Gio.
When I need motivation, my one solution is my queen. She's always in my corner, right there when I wanna. All these other girls are tempting, but I'm empty when you're gone. And they say, do you need me? Do you think I'm prepared? Do I make you feel like cheating? I'm like, no, not really, cause oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. She is always right there when I need her. Oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. She is always right there when I need her.
And most definitely, folks, come this Sunday, we will have cheerleaders because the Digicel Girls will be here. We will have lots of entertainment. The songs of Pretty, A Second Star, and a lot more. So remember, this Sunday, 14th June, from 5 p.m., be sure to come out early and get your seats. It's going to be a ram-packed house.
Ayo, chill.
When I need motivation, my one solution is my queen, cause she stays strong. Yeah, yeah. She is always in my corner, right there when I wanna. All these other girls are tempting, but I'm empty when you're gone. And they say, do you need me? Do you think I'm pretty? You feel like cheating? I'm like, no, not really, cause oh, I think that always right there when I need her. Oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. She is always right there when I need her.
So the second innings of this encounter about to get on the way. The opening pair of Sheldon Thomas and David, aka Bombay Parag. This is the opening pair for the Heineken Hotshots team, and they have the task ahead of them. They're in search of 67 runs for victory from their allotted 7 overs, as we see Wendell Allen, the opening bowler for the Sagicor Grandy Boys team.
Bang, bang, bang.
So Wendell Allen to continue from the commentary end. He comes into Thomas, the batsman on strike. Remember, folks, 67 runs required for victory. Just under 10 runs and over. As Allen comes into Thomas. And what a shot there from Thomas. That ball just going straight over the extra cover area. Four runs coming from it. So the Heineken Hotshots team on their way. Four runs on their scorecard. Four runs to Sheldon Thomas. So Allen to continue into Thomas. Thomas just driving that ball back down to Allen. No run on that occasion. A nail-biting match this is here, folks. Remember, it's win or go home. So Allen into Thomas. And Thomas just playing that ball down the long area. And he picks up four more runs. So he seems to be batting aggressively. He is running this 67 runs down. Apparently he has the go ahead from his skipper. The score now moving on to 8 without loss. So Allen with his final delivery. So at the end of over number one, the score 8 for no loss. Heineken Hot Shots on their way in search of 67 for victory. So Ravi Khan, the new bowler, he'll be coming from the coconut tree end. Remember folks, this Sunday we have lots of treats in store. A popcorn, cotton candy, snow cone, entertainment. And in this division, it's a $15,000 up for grabs, the first place prize. A $10,000 for the second place, $5,000 for the third place, and $2,500 for the fourth place in this first division. In the premier division, the first prize stands at a massive $30,000. The second prize, $20,000. Third prize, $15,000. And fourth prize, $10,000. So, it's a lot of money up for grabs here in this competition. As we see, umpire Cox signaling a wide delivery here from Khan. The batsman on strike, David Pariag, seeing his first delivery. So Khan to continue into Pariag. And Parag, they're just picking up his first run. So the total now moving on to 10 without loss. Batsman on strike now, Sheldon Thomas. Khan coming into him. Big heave there from Thomas. So Khan into Thomas once again. Thomas making contact here. Driving that ball straight back down the pitch. Picking up a single. And that brings Parag back on strike. Remember, both these batsmen are very, very dangerous. A known batsman right here on this grounds. So Ravi Khan to continue. Pariag not making contact. So Khan still with two more deliveries. He comes in with his fifth delivery. The reverse shot being attempted there by Pariag. A wide ball signal by the umpire. Total now moving on to 12 without loss. So Pariag makes connection. And that ball going down to Alvarez, it seems like. Yes, it is. So Pariag picking up another single. He moves on to 2. Thomas on 9. And this total on 13. Khan with his final delivery. And Batiste just making a mess of that field. And the batsman scampering through here. This could be a run out. A third umpire being called upon. So Parag could be in some trouble. We'll see what the third umpire has to say in just a short shot. Holding it down in the meantime, DJ Gio. Done. Done. Done.
Me no know who she get to. But me here say she get to it. Natalie say, he say, she say she get to it. True. But a good thing me made for. Come on, I must believe it. No, me see it say. I can't believe it. I can't believe it.
a try to find a way fi give me to. No for them just want to climb up on the pinnacle. Them just want to that me the child them want to pin it to. Them say that for every man you give it to. Well, you know them see your body, them a see me to. Well, them a watch and chat, you not a thing you do to me. Cause me no listen, me not left you all pain. You have pain, man. Me a fi be living. Me never ask them to watch your body. If you need that, me a tell them. All when them say six, but girl, yes, who makes seven? Girl, everybody say feel nice, but feel like say me them in
heaven. I wanna do a wind up on me, so
thank you there to the Third Empire, David Pariak, being spared a close encounter. So he would live to continue his fight, and in a search of 67 runs for victory. The score now 15 without loss. That's the end of over number two. Over number three about to get underway. So Avin Charles, the new bowler, he'll be coming from the commentary end or the pie man end. The batsman on strike, David Pariag. So Charles into Pariag, and Pariag making contact. That ball just going over the wicketkeeper's head. That should be Harry. So Pariag picking up another single. This total now moving on to 16. So this is over number three, folks. Remember, it's 67 runs required for victory. The crowd just going silent here. A nail-biting game this is, as Charles continues now to Thomas. Thomas there just slashing that ball, and what a shot that is. A remarkable shot there by Thomas. Four runs and a no ball signal by the umpire. We will see exactly what this no ball is about.
Attention!
And it's a free hit. So Avin Charles just overstepping his line. So a free hit here awarded to the Heineken Hot Shots team. The batsman on strike, Sheldon Thomas. So he will have a strike at this. So Charles to continue. This is a free hit. Big swing there from Thomas. This goes all the way. So Thomas making the maximum use of this free hit. He picks up 7 runs for his team. The total now 28 without loss.
trend them to block the show.
So chill,
chill.
Big, big,
big, big, big.
So Charles into Thomas. Another sweet shot there by Sheldon Thomas. Four more. So Charles to continue, Sheldon Thomas, the batsman on strike, he's on 26. Charles into Thomas, a big swing, this could be seven more, so that's a maximum. This total now moving on to 39, the place is alive. Heineken hot shots are moving forward quickly. A summer. I see some serious destruction taking place here, folks. Just some 24 runs coming off of Charles over so far. Just a four deliveries bowled. He still has two more. The score now 39 without loss. So Charles into Thomas. A much better delivery there from Charles. A quicker delivery. So one more ball remaining in his over. So an excellent comeback there from Avin Charles. Just settling things down. He comes in with his final delivery into Thomas. And Thomas just flashing there a wide ball signal by umpire Burgos. So Charles will have to bowl that over. So make that 25 now from this over. Charles with his final delivery and Thomas just clipping that ball off his legs. So at the end of over number three, the score 41 without loss, 26 runs coming from that over. An expensive over there for the Sagicor Grandy Boys team. A much welcomed over for the Heineken Hotshots team. They're in search of 67 for victory. The score 41 without loss, as I hand you over to DJ Gio.
Girl link me for WhatsApp. From she link she no Snapchat. Tell me say she want wine pa me pad. She say the signal good me have the hot spot. And her favorite position a position. Say she want it all night she no knock shop. Go down pan a red she a bad black. Bad girl she a 21 in a cash man. No go she open up the sun like a laptop. Me want see me some little off the drop top. Disturb the neighbors them no stop knock. Me a work me no stop rock. From you say girl is thing me a black.
So quite a lot of discussions in the field here by the Sagicor Grandy Boys team. Remember, folks, that this is no time for Skylark. It's a win or go home. We see two sets of huddles in the field. These Sagicor Grandy Boys players needing to find a solution for the pair of Thomas and Pariag, bringing on some sort of destruction here. The score 41 without loss. Remember, they're in search of 67 for victory. Just 26 runs required from 24 balls. So this is going to be a tight one, folks, as we see this new bowler coming from the coconut tree ends. It seems as though it's Wendell Allen. Yes, it is. So he has been brought back in to try to contain these batsmen. So he'll be appearing for his second over. Remember, he was the opening bowler. Conceding only 8 runs in his first over. He will come into Thomas, the batsman on strike, the man bringing all the destruction to this team so far. So it's Wendell Allen to continue from the coconut tree end, the western end. And Thomas, the man on strike, picking up a single here. And that brings the Pariag on strike. Oh, and another chance of a run out here. So a leg by signal from umpire Cox. So both these batsmen, just a quick discussion in the center. So Thomas back on strike, Allen to continue. He comes into Thomas. Thomas driving that ball out to the extra cover area. That's 4 runs. So some excellent cricket strokes here from Sheldon Thomas. The batsman in the center. This opening pair between Thomas and Pariag. Bringing on some sort of onslaught here. Score now 47 without loss. 20 more runs required for victory, folks. So Allen into Thomas once again. So that ball going straight into the center of Thomas's legs. So 20 runs from 20 balls. It's a runner ball from here, folks. So we will see who is it going to be. Allen into Thomas. Foolish delivery. Thomas picking up a single here. That ball going out to the mid-wicket area. Mikel Barrett, the fieldsman. So Allen now with his final delivery. And Pariag picks up this one clean. And that one clears the boundary. It's over the fence. 7 more to this total. So at the end of over number 5, the total 55 of without loss.
Jan, come on to me. Come over here and perform for me. Jan, come on to me. Turn up your temperature, make you warm for me. Jan, come on to me. Jan, come on to me. Jan, come on to me. Come over here and perform for me.
Wine like a gypsy, from left hand to right she a swing there. Wanna try get the girl fling way, but then I feel the vibe rhythm of it. Need you over right there with me there, but inna your phone and we're not free me. She not realize I am the DJ, so me take up the mic and then say, girl ya the bomb, the bomb, the bomb, the bomb, 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 diggy diggy bring come give it to me. Girl ya the bomb, the bomb, the bomb, the bomb, 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 diggy diggy bring come give it to me, give it to me, girl, give it to me, girl, give it to me, give it to me, give it to me, girl.
So at the end of over number 4, the score 55 without loss. Remember, folks, 12 runs away from victory, this Heineken Hotshots team, as we see number 20 Ryan Quilden with the ball in hand. He'll be coming from the commentary end. The opening pair of Sheldon Thomas and David Pariag still in the center. Both these batsmen really doing it to this Sagico Grandi Boys team. Pariag on 10. And Thomas on a 4-0-40. So an excellent opening partnership between these two batsmen. Really putting their heads down and holding it down for their team. This is where you have to come big. It's win or go home. So Quilden into Thomas. Shortish delivery. This is up in the air. And he is going to be out. So Thomas is on his way. He has to depart after some four overs. The first ball of the fifth over. Ryan Quillen picks up the wicket of the dangerous. Sheldon Thomas, as he is cheered on from the spectators. He makes 38 runs. As we see the skipper, the captain of the Heineken Hotshots team, Darren Cupidor, the son of the man, Gary Cupidor. He comes to the center. And hopefully he steers things home for his team.
You wanna be a bitch, just reset. Look on your body, there no evidence. So, step up, that is a big statement. Fire up, just
say, put them in the place, put them in the place, put them in the place. Just like that, I want you put them in the place. Put them in the place, put them in the place. Just like that, God, you got the juice. You got the juice, you got the juice. Thanks to your mama, girl, you got the juice. You got the juice, you got the juice.
Attention! As we say thank you to DJ Geo and the mix master, the scratch man, none other than Dan. And just some words of wisdom from Dan there. He said music is the fruit of life. So Ryan Quillen to continue. He just picked up the wicket of Sheldon Thomas. He's coming into Cupidor. And that one just bouncing over the wicket of Cupidor. So two deliveries bowled by Quilden. A dot ball and a wicket. So Quilden to continue. He comes into Cupidor. Big swing there from Cupidor and a thick edge. So Cupidor is walking. He is on his way. And Quilden picks up his second wicket. Cupidor goes for a duck. The duck man is out on the field and he's dancing away. He picks up a wicket as well. He's on about 252. So duck man, the leading wicket taker in this competition so far.
Every time when you pass my road, you do me something when you can't control. Can you plenty, can I get more? Put up on me, can I get more? Pretty girl from a far chateau, see the long, my neck shiny nose bone. Can you plenty, can I get more? Put up on me, can I get more? Cranberry with the any, me have a fat high grade with the many. Me a go rough up the world, rough up the world, rough it up. Rough up the world, rough up the world, rough it up. Me can't stand up steady.
I don't chill,
and
chill.
I know I'm a jive when me ready. Me a go rough up the world, rough up the world, rough it up. Rough up the world, rough up the world, rough it up.
So we'll take you back to the Sesame Street, folks. So what rhymes with man? Yes, it's Dan the Scratch Man. So thank you there, Dan the Scratch Man, for some sweet sounds. And he will also be here come this Sunday, 14th June, for the finals. So Josiah Grisette comes to the center after Daryl Cupidor was caught out. So Quilden picking up another wicket. And an important wicket of that. The skipper, Cupidor, he has to depart. He went for a duck. Josiah Grisette on strike now. Pariaga is still out in the center. Quilden comes into Grisette. And this ball beats the wicketkeeper. It goes down to the boundary. A fieldsman coming around.
Bang, bang,
he
bang.
Stops the four runs. So a leg by signal by the umpire. Just a one run coming from that delivery there. We see David Pariag coming on strike now. The score now, 56 for the loss of two. So Quillen into Pariag. Pariag taking that on the knees. So some excellent bowling here from Ryan Quilden. Remember, he has been around this circuit for quite some time, so he knows exactly what it takes. Quilden to continue into Pariag. Pariag making contact. Chance of a run out. And that one seems to hit the wicket cleanly. We'll just wait for the... Yes, it is. So Pariag has to go. He has been run out. The third wicket now falling for the Heineken Hotshots team. The score 56 for the loss of three. and the Sagicor Brandy Boys team making their way back in this game.
When the lover come down for you, girl can't be left behind for you. Girl can't be left behind for you. When the lover come down for you, girl can't be left behind for you. Girl can't be left behind for you. She said she can't wait. She said the lover come down. She can't wait. She said the lover come down.
Girl, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. Girl, welcome back on the winding truck. Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. Put your bag of mustard on, we'll be shot.
And my eyes are set on a young lady in a top here sitting on top of the pavilion, and it seems as though she can't wait. She wants her love to come down.
Bang, 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 bang.
Flicky, flicky, are you there?
You like that, huh?
So Keston Kipido comes to the center. He replaces David Pariag after he was unluckily run out. So Ryan Sarup, the new bowler. And this is over number six. Sarup will be coming from the western end or the coconut tree end. So 11 runs required from 12 deliveries here now, folks. An excellent excellent over being bowled by Ryan Quilden. Just a one run for two wickets coming from that over. So Sarup into Cupido. And Cupido picking up a single, so he's off the mark. So now 10 runs from 11 balls. This is Super Sevens cricket action, folks. SFX Super Sevens cricket action. This is what it comes down to. One of these teams will be going home. Who will it be? Who is your money on? Is it the insurance team? The beer team? Who is your money on? As we hear shouts of hot shots from the barman. Why? Because I think he was sponsored some cases of Heineken, so he has no choice but to back this team.
You like that, huh?
Flicky, flicky.
So Sarup to Sarup to continue. So some excellent bowling here from Ryan Sarup. As we see things just getting tense. So 10 from 9. Grazet, the man on strike. So 10 from 8, things are getting even tighter here, folks. The Grandy Boys team picking up some momentum and finding their way back into this game. Two more deliveries remaining in Sarup's over. Just one run coming from it so far. He comes into Grazet. A scramble here. So Kipido makes his way back down on the striker's end. One more delivery to go. Total now moving on now to 58. Nine more needed from seven deliveries. Things are building up, folks. The crowd goes silent. So Sarup with his final delivery. The left-handed Keston Kipido on strike. Sarup comes in. A swing and a miss there from Cupid. Also, at the end of over, number six, the score,
yeah!
58 for the loss of two.
Corrupted song.
Nine more runs required for victory from six deliveries. And my mistake, it's 58 for the loss of three. Remember, folks, nine more needed for victory.
Right now, my
different problems
side.
Super fresh sound.
Tonight I did bandit.
I
don't
chill, chill.
I do my own, I am searching. Somehow I must take home something. Good lad, tonight I must pick a pumpkin. I look in
the chill.
I want some cookies tonight. I look in some nookie tonight. Just a little nookie tonight.
So this is it, folks. Four Roads Recreational Grounds. This is the seventh and final over of this game. 9 runs needed for victory from 6 deliveries, 6 legal deliveries. Who is it going to be? One of these teams will have to pack their bags. Somebody will be going home. Somebody will be coming back on Wednesday. Who will it be? Mikel Barrett, the new bowler from the commentary end. He'll be bowling the final over for his team. The batsman on strike, Josiah Grisette. On the non-strikers end, Keston Cupidor. So the intensity builds, 6 balls, 9 runs. This is it. Is it youth or experience? Somebody is going home this evening, folks. Who will it be? 9 runs from 6 balls. Mikel Barrett with his first delivery. He comes into Grisette. A big swing. This one is up in the air. Fieldsman coming around. He's under it and he's held on. So Grisette is on his way. Another wicket falling for the Heineken Hudson team. Yeah, and that's a duck here for Josiah Grisette. The duck man are now taking the field. The Sagicor Grandy boys are celebrating there in the center, and there's why. So the veteran Trevor Rajkumar coming to the center, and he replaces Josiah Grisette after he was caught out. So Mikel Barrett picking up a wicket, and all sorts of discussions in this field here, folks. 5 more deliveries to go and 9 more runs for victory. Who will it be? Tonight is the night. There's no coming back after tonight. It's win or go home. So Barrett to continue. He'll be coming into the left-handed Keston Cupidor. Bang. So ball number 2. And a wide ball here. So still 5 more deliveries remaining. Wide signal by umpire Burgos. And that total just inching closer and closer. 8 more runs from 5 deliveries. Mikel Barrett just changing his approach. He's now coming over the wicket to Cupidor. He comes in. A swing and a miss. That ball just getting under the bat of Barrett of Cupidor. So things just getting even more tense, folks. The score 59 for the loss of 4. 8 more runs needed for victory. Just four more deliveries remaining in this game. Spectators on their feet. Baratin to Cupido. Big swing and a miss. So it's now 8-3. Who is it going to be, folks? It's getting tighter and tighter. That vice grip just closing in now. 8 more runs from 3 deliveries. One of these teams will be going home. It's nervousness all around the grounds. So Barat to continue. So Barat into Cupido. Another swing and a miss. So it's now 8 more runs from 2 deliveries. It's getting closer and closer and closer, folks, as we hear the irate spectators all around the grounds. 8 runs from 2 deliveries. This is the deciding ball. Barat comes into Cupido. And a wide ball signaled by umpire Bogos. So 7-2. It could be over in one hit, folks. Just one hit away from a victory. Just 2 balls away from a victory. Who will it be? The Sagico Grandi boys. The Heineken Hotshots. One of these teams are going home. It's either green or blue. Who are you behind?
Bang, bang, bang.
Two more deliveries, folks. 2 more deliveries. Barat into Cupido. This is up in the air. Fieldsman around. He's gone. So 7 more from 1 delivery. This game isn't over. And yet, Keston Cupido has to be part. He goes. He goes for one. What is the feeling you have?
You're right, doctor.
Good night. Flicky, flicky. I don't know. Good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night.
So the dog pound is open, folks.
Attention!
So Brandon Singh coming to the center. He replaces Keston Cupido. He went for one. The batsman on strike, Trevor Rajkumar. 7 balls needed from this final delivery. 7 runs, sorry.
You like that, huh?
I only have the white oak to blame for that, Ken. So this is it, folks. One more ball to go. Seven runs needed. This is what it comes down to. So final delivery. So that's it, folks.
Attention!
The Sagico Grandi Boys team will move forward. They will make their way back here on Wednesday to play the Flavorite Avengers. The Heineken Hotshots are not able to meet the 67 runs required for victory. And Timothy Suklal, Mikael Barrett, Ryan Quilden, Akeem Alvarez, the manager and all his players, Chris Patia, the skipper, they have all right to celebrate some excellent cricket on their part. They will be coming back on Wednesday against the Flavorite Avengers. Remember, tomorrow it's Autorama Gunners against the SCCL Hard Drive. The Big Screen Spartans come up against the Earth to Move Hammers. That's tomorrow. On Wednesday, it's Carib Oilers playing Surprise Utes.